Assalamu alaikum rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Today we are going to learn our second chapter, that is animals and human beings. Okay, this is our second chapter. Take out page number 155 in your science readers. See, animals and human beings. Human beings are classified as belonging to the animal kingdom. We are, means human beings are classified as belonging to the animal kingdom. We are belonging to the animal kingdom only. Human beings walk erect while most animals move on all four limbs, right? We can move with our legs only, but most of the animals are walk with their four limbs. Think of the few other differences between animals and human beings. There are many differences, right, with between the human beings and the animals, there are many differences are there. For example, think about their eyes, their mouth, brain, legs, hands, and the horns, tails, and the teeth of animals, right? They have the different eyes. We also have the different eyes. Animals have the different mouth, different legs, hands, and we are also having the different mouths, different hands, legs, and so on. Okay, let's see some features of human beings. Human beings walk in an upright position, right? As you can see here in this picture, the girl is moving in the upright position. This leads their upper limbs free to do many things. Human beings have a thumb and can use their hands to hold tools and do many things. Will we are walking with the our legs, then our hands are free now. So with the help of our hands, we can do many things. We can hold the things. We can do many works with the help of our hands. Animals such as apes, gorillas, chimpanzees, monkeys, and so on share some features with human beings. Means these all animals have some features same as us. They have 5 fingers and 5 toes, right? We are also having in one hand, we are having 5 fingers. In one leg, we are having the 5 toes. Likewise, gorillas, chimpanzees, and monkeys also have the same. They have also 5 fingers in their hand and 5 toes in their legs. And the toenails and the fingernails also. They too walk upright, use their upper limbs, but not as much as human beings do. Means chimpanzee and gorilla also walk with their legs and they have their upper limbs. They can hold the things and do the things, but not as much as we can do. Animals such as apes, monkeys, and the human beings which have thumbs, toes, and front-facing eyes are known as the primates. Okay? Then human beings have another advantage. Their backbone. We are having our backbone now. With the help of our backbone, we can bend forward, backward, sideways. Okay? And human beings can speak in many languages. We can speak in many languages now. Animals also make themselves understood in some ways. Animals also communicate with them, with each other in their own language. Okay, now we'll see an animation of this.
Human beings walk in an upright position and do many things with their hands. But animals cannot walk upright. Apes, monkeys, and human beings which have thumbs, toes, and front-facing eyes are known as primates. Human beings have backbone. Using the backbone, human beings can bend forward, backward, and sideways. Human beings can speak many languages. Animals also communicate among themselves.
Okay. These are the some features of human beings and animals. Next, we'll continue our class in the next class. Thank you.